Hi students, so welcome to Chemistry Online. In our first class already we discussed about blueprint, and then next in this class in our first class blueprint we discussed, in second class types of introduction about what is solution, what is solute, what is solvent, and types of solutions we discussed. In this class we are going to discuss a important concept, concentration of solutions. Concentration of solutions. So first of all, you know what is concentration. Concentration of solutions. So first of all, you know what is a concentration. Concentration means the maximum amount of the amount of solute dissolved in 100 grams of solvent. The amount of solute dissolved in 100 grams of the solvent is nothing but concentration. The maximum amount of solute dissolved in corresponding solvent is called concentration. So we have many methods to express concentration. For example, 100 ml water we are taking, 10 grams sugar we are added, that is one concentration. 100 ml water we are taking, 20 grams sugar added, that is one concentration. Means depending concentration is depends upon the number of moles of the solute added to solvent, that is nothing but concentration. So we have many methods to express concentration. The first one is nothing but methods of expressing concentration, of expressing concentration. So methods of expressing concentration. So first one is nothing but mass percent means mass percent means, so here the number of grams of solute or the amount of solute in grams dissolved in 100 grams of solution. The amount of solute dissolved in 100 grams of solution is called mass percent. The amount of solute dissolved in the amount of solute in grams dissolved in or per 100 grams of solution. The amount of solute in grams dissolved per or dissolved in dissolved per 100 grams of solution is called mass percent. So here we have a formula for mass percent. This is nothing but weight by weight. This is equal to mass of the solute by mass of solute by mass of solution into 100. Mass percent equal to weight by weight equal to mass of the solute by mass of the solution. Solution means solute plus solvent. Solution means solute plus solvent. it is nothing but a mass of a solution. For example, we may say one example 5% mass by mass of glucose means, for example, 5% mass, weight by weight means mass by mass of glucose C6H12O6 means 5 grams of C6H12O6 in 100 grams of solution. 5 grams of C6H12O6 in 100 grams of solution means here solute is glucose, solvent is water. So 5 grams of C6H12O6 in 95 grams of water. 100 grams of solution are glucose, 5 grams of C6H12O6 means glucose. 5 grams of C6H12O6 and 95 grams of water. 95 grams of water. It is nothing but methods of expressing concentration. First one, mass percent. Mass percent. Okay, this is. Next, volume percent. Next, volume percent. Next, second one is volume percent. Volume percent. Okay. So here, solute volume we have to take, solvent volume we have to take. This is number of parts of volume, number of parts of volume of solute, number of parts of volume of solute in number of parts of 100 volumes of a solution. Number of parts of volume of the solute in 100 and then in number of parts of 100 volumes of the solution. This is in 100 volume of the solution. Here we have to take volume percent means here solute volume we have to take and solvent volume we have to take or solution volume we have to take. This is V by V. Volume percent means this is V by V. So for this definition we have to write the number of parts of volumes of solute, the number of parts of volumes of solute per number of parts of 100 volume, 100 volume of the solution. The number of parts of volume of the solute per number of parts of 100 volumes. 100 volumes of the solution is called volume percent. Then volume percent is equal to volume of solute by volume of solution into 100. Here volume of the solute, a number of parts of volume of solute, or number of parts of volume of the solution. This is nothing but volume of the solute present in 100 ml of the solution. The volume of the solute present in 100 ml of the solution simply. Okay. So for example, 5% V by V of C2H5OH means 5 ml of C2H5OH in 100 ml of solution. 100 ml of solution. This is nothing but 5% volume by volume of ethyl alcohol. It means 5 ml of ethyl alcohol in 100 ml of solution. Means 5 ml is ethyl alcohol and 95 ml is water. That is nothing but a solvent. So here 5 ml C2H5OH and 95 ml H2O. Stand. This is the way volume percent means concentration of solutions, methods of expressing concentration. So volume percent, the previous one mass percent. Next we are going to discuss mass by volume percent means. So got it? This is an example. Next we are going to discuss mass by volume percent. Then third one is mass by volume percent. Mass by volume percent. It is nothing but weight by volume. It is nothing but weight by volume. Here solute we have to take grams. Here we have to take a solute weight and solvent volume. Solute weight we have to take, weight and solvent volume we have to take. This is nothing but weight. Okay, then what is mass by volume percent means? The number of means amount of solute in grams present in 100 ml of the solution. The amount of solute in grams, the amount of solute in grams, the amount of solute in 100 ml of the solution, the amount of the solute grams in 100 ml of the solution. For example, this is a definition. For example, 20% of sodium hydroxide, 20% of 20 mass by volume means weight by volume, 20 weight by volume percent of sodium hydroxide. It means 20 grams of sodium hydroxide in 80 grams of water. It means 20 grams of sodium hydroxide, 80 ml. Sorry, mass by volume na 80 ml of H2O. It means 20 grams of sodium hydroxide and 80 ml of solute is sodium hydroxide, solvent is H2O. Okay, this is nothing but mass by volume percent. So first what we discussed, mass percent is weight by weight. Next what we discussed, volume percent, volume by volume. Next what we are going to discuss, what we discussed, mass by volume. Then what we are going to discuss, mass by volume is over now. Next we are going to discuss ppm, means parts per million. Ppm means parts per million. Okay, then fourth one is parts per million. Parts per million, it is nothing but ppm. Parts per million, it is nothing but ppm. So this is the expressing concentration method we are going to use. Very minute particles of the solute present in the solvent. Very minute means very very less minute particles of the solute present in the solution, means very very less amount of the solute present in the solvent. Then here parts per million means number of parts of the solute, the amount of solute means are number of parts of the solute present in 1 million parts of the solution. That is nothing but parts per million. The number of parts of solute, the number of parts of solute in 1 million parts, 1 million parts of the 1 million parts of the solution. Of the solution, the number of parts of the solute in 1 million parts of the solution is called ppm. So 1 ppm is equal to, ppm is equal to mass of solute by mass of solution into 10^6. Mass of the solute by mass of the solution into 10^6, it is called 1 ppm. So for example 5 ppm, means okay, for example 5 ppm, it means it means 5 grams of solute in 10 power 6 grams of solution. 5 grams of solute in 10 power 6 grams of solution. It is nothing but 5 ppm. So what I mean to say, very very much, only 5 grams in 10 power 6 grams of the solution. So it means 5 grams of the solute in 10 power 6 grams of the solution. Very very less quantity of solute present in 10 power 6 grams of solution. It is called parts per million. It is called parts per million. So this is the way we may express. For example, 5 ppm of CaCl2 means 5 grams of CaCl2 in 10 power 6 grams of solution. 10 power 6 grams of solution. This is the way we may discuss concentration of the solutions, methods of expressing concentration. Methods of expressing concentration. Methods of expressing concentration. So what is concentration means? The amount of the solute dissolved in a solvent is called concentration simply. What is concentration means? The amount of the solute dissolved in solvent. Dissolved in the solvent is called concentration. So this is the way we may express concentration. So next, some more important methods we are going to discuss. Molarity, molality, mole fraction we are going to discuss. So before we are going to discuss these, first of all you have to get an idea about second year chemistry. See, comparing to first year, second year chemistry is very difficult. If you work properly, if you learn time to time, if you follow online classes perfectly, then only you will get 100% of the marks in chemistry. So syllabus is more, total 13 chapters in the first year chemistry, and second year chemistry also we have 13 chapters, but according to syllabus, in 13 chapters many chapters is given. Suppose if you take sixth A group, so 4 chapters is given, means P block elements. P block elements means that is nothing but 4 chapters is given. 4 chapters are combinedly given in one P block elements, that which carries 12 marks. So previously 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th groups are considered to be as 4 chapters, but these 4 chapters given in one chapter here, which carries 12 marks. Next, chemical kinetics and electrochemistry, these two chapters are separately given in previous for previous students, but recently means from 5 to 6 years, chemical kinetics and electrochemistry are commonly given in one chapter, which carries 10 marks. So the syllabus is a maximum 13 chapters, even though we have 13 chapters, but in 13 chapters 20 chapters is given, nearly 20 chapters is given. So for finishing this syllabus, so already we lost 40 to 50 days time. So for finishing this these chapters, you have to work hard time to time, then only you will get more marks in second year chemistry. So why I started solutions as the first chapter means, it carries 6 marks. It is very important chapter for objective type and IP also. So we, for IP, it carries 6 marks, one short answer and one very short. For MCET, 2 questions you are going to get. For NEET, nearly 9% of the questions weightage. I am telling, for NEET, 9% of the questions you are going to get from this chapter. Okay, that's where I started. So this is our third class. In first class, what we discussed means blueprint and IP paper pattern already you know. In second class, solutions introduction we discussed solute, solvent, solution, next types of solutions. Next in third class, it is the third class, we are discussing concentration. What is a concentration? And next expressing concentration methods. Some of the concentration methods we discussed mass percent, volume percent, mass by volume percent, and PPM, parts per million, okay, living.